moving on. VA 2022-14.
Thank you, Madam Chairman. This is also a rezoning request for 0.32 acres, rezoning from single family residential R13 to residential professional. Property is located at 202 Lane Avenue. As you see from the zoning map on the screen, it is all R15 along the north side of Lane Avenue, single family neighborhood. You see a lot of RP zoning to the south. That is somewhat misleading because most everything on the south side is also single family residential, including the Fairfield subdivision straight to the south. Transitional character area on the comprehensive plan future development map. But you know, transitional neighborhood is one of those where it can swing either way. You either put measures in place to protect the neighborhood, or you add or increase the zoning to facilitate the transition. So the comprehensive plan addresses it both ways, either to be transitioned or to be protected from transition. In this case, Wayne Avenue, I believe, served really as a border between different zoning patterns. Although the land use pattern is single family all along the corridor. It's not until you get closer to Patterson to the east or Park Avenue to the south as you start getting into more of the professional office environment. Aerial imagery, you see rooftops, these are all houses. The only non-residential property, which is a little bit off the screen to the right, is a former residence on the corner of Coons and Wayne, which is a small law. Which in this case is what the applicants are proposing. They are attorneys. They are proposing to convert the property to a regular professional office, not some occupation or home business, but a regular law office. It's not entirely clear if they would convert the existing building, add parking to the driveways, or if they would demolish the building and develop the site immediately. Either way, it would take the zoning change facilitate that. Survey is in your pack that gives the dimensions, site sketch that also gives a floor plan of the house. They have a circular drive in the front that stub out driveways to the backyard. They can hold a few spaces, but as a conventional professional office, they're going to need a parking lot, whether it be in the front or in the back or a little bit of both. Again, the zoning pattern R15, RP to the south. I make note, mention in your packet of some history. The property immediately to the east, I think this was in 2009, was proposed for the exact same zoning change for a real estate office. That met with some opposition. Planning Commission recommended denial of that with a 7-0 vote, and then it was withdrawn before it reached the City Council. So that's there as a footnote of information. So with all of that, staff is recommending denial of this, finding it inconsistent with the standards for exercise of zoning power and the comprehensive plan in general. I'm glad to answer any questions you may have on this one.
I have a question about parking. What would be the recommended number of parking spots for a law office?
Depends on the size of the building. The minimum requirement is 3 spaces per 1,000 square feet of gross floor area. So it would be 1.7 times 3. And it would be 5 point something, so it rounds up to 6 spaces, if I do the math correctly.
Okay.
That would be the minimum. If they were to demolish the building and start over, then it's based on what the site plan can hold. That triggers landscaping requirements, stormwater requirements, and so forth.
The rezoning is not going to trigger those landscaping requirements.
Rezoning by itself is not. It's just development or redevelopment of the property.
Right.
If they were to add pavement to put in parking spaces, and just as an example, say we could put 3 in the front yard, 3 in the back, it depends on the quantity of pavement that you have. And once you hit, I think, 500 square feet, the percentage of the value of the improvements to the property will start triggering the landscaping requirements. Until you hit 50% value, that will trigger 100% of the requirements. So it depends on exactly.
nicer.
Well, in some of the pictures, and I forgot we had pictures, subject property, existing residence, circular drive. As you look eastward down Wayne Avenue toward Patterson, this is what you see. Driveways, mailboxes, homes, house to the west on the subject property, a house to the east. This is looking up North Tomb Street northward from near the subject property again, the neighborhood continues northward. This is the Fairfield property to the south. And then the house immediately to the diagonal southwest, where the newer home is built. It's a small home, a relatively small lot, but it's an RV, which allows for high density, kind of residential, even a single family.
Any questions for staff?
Matt, you said the RP on this map, on the corner down the street, was a law office?
Correct, and if you can barely see it in this photo, use some imagination. But if you were to go toward Patterson, you hit the other leg of North Tombs. William Weitzel has his office there.
Okay.
It used to be a residence a long time ago, but that's the only thing on this road corridor that's not a single family home.
And what is that little tiny RP almost directly across from the...
That's Fairfield.
You see a little teeny house footprint lots?
Yeah.
It's condominium, a cluster of houses.
Right.
RP allows single family homes. In fact, we have entire neighborhoods. The Highlands neighborhood, which is about 250 houses, is all zoned RP. Which if it weren't for covenants, we could have offices and apartments in there. But that is a long story as to how that evolved, but it's not completely done much. This is just a small area. But what this does is emphasize that the zoning pattern and the land use pattern don't match.
Yep. All right, if there are no other discussion, I'll open it up. Is there anyone here tonight who would like to speak on behalf of this request? If you'll come forward, please.
Okay.
Hi.
I'm Carrie Ann Bowden. Live at 202 Wayne Avenue. I am the applicant, one of the applicants. My husband and I are the applicants. As Mr. Martin said, we are both attorneys. We don't have any current plans to convert from our primary residence to a law office. We both are currently employed with other law offices in town and don't have any plans of changing that. But it has been our intention for many, many years now to one day have our own practice. And just like Mr. Martin and y'all do on a regular basis as far as planning and looking toward the future, that is what we're doing. And if we are not going to be able to have our office at this location, then we're going to look into selling it, renting it out, possibly something else, but to move out of that area. And I know as part of really one of the goals of a transitional neighborhood is to have owner-occupied buildings, and that is what we are trying to maintain by being able to convert this potentially one day to an office. There has been some increased crime in the area. About 5 years ago or so, 4 or 5 years ago, our home was broken into during the day, right before noon. Because there's not a whole lot of people around. And on the very same day, our neighbor to the west, her home was broken into on that very same day. And so we believe that having some daytime presence in the area would help with that. I also think that the mention of this being a residential neighborhood is not quite accurate. And I don't know that I have a copy for all of y'all, but I do have several copies of a more wider Center Street. There is also RP down Tomb Street, even on the block, so on the northwest corner of the block that our home sits on, which is actually on the corner, I think of Gornto and Oak Street, is an RP development or zoning as well. Again, on the northwest corner across Oak Street is also RP. There's RP and other professional offices, even up Tombs and toward the east. And again, and I'm happy to hand you the alleys.
We can pass it down.
Bill asked about the other law office. That is actually on the corner of North Tombs and Wayne Avenue. I don't know if the numbers are on your packets, but at 2209, actually a Tomb Street property. 202 West Park Avenue is also a law office, so directly a block south of the subject property is a law office. And so we believe it very much fits into consistency of the general neighborhood. Mr. Martin brought up potential plans and whether we intend to demolish the actual structure there. We don't have any plans of doing that if this zoning application were to be approved. And if, and this is a bunch of ifs, and we could come up with a million different hypotheticals, but if one day it was converted to our office space, our intention would be to use the current structure, very much like the law offices on Patterson Street that are the old homes that have been converted into law offices. We do have a good bit of space in the front yard and the backyard, a good bit of pavement already there, but again, because there are no plans to actually convert immediately and begin business out of the structure, we have no plans to pave and all of that. We do understand that in the future, if that were the case, then there would be other conditions that we would have to meet as that goes along. There are also other businesses along that Wayne Avenue. So Wayne Avenue is about two blocks long between Patterson and Oak Street. Toward the Patterson end, there is a group of apartments, basically, on the corner of Patterson and Wayne Avenue, but directly across, so that would be on the southeast corner, I guess, of Wayne Avenue. There is insurance offices, a couple of different business offices along that way. So again, we believe that this zoning application directly fits into the purpose of the transitional neighborhood. We believe it would be good for the neighborhood if it were to be approved, and we would ask that it be approved, and I'm happy to answer any questions that the council may have.
If this were approved, Matt, could we condition it that it would revert back to original zoning? No? Once it's rezoned,
zoning changes cannot happen all night.
Okay. It's done.
We would have to, or someone would have to initiate a public hearing process and change it back.
Gotcha.
It's not like conditional use or plan developments, it's kind of an expiration date.
Right, and we could put conditions on. Yeah. All right. Any questions for our speaker? All right, thank you so much.
Would you like to do that, ma'am?
All right, thank you. All right, if we have time, we'll do. Okay, so we do have a couple of minutes if there's someone else who would like to speak on behalf of this request. All right, if not, is there anyone who would wish to speak against this request, if you'll come forward? Anyone wishing to speak against?
My name's Marsha Alexander, and I own the property directly across from them, and Fairfield Place is not my residence. 2217 is a rental property. But I just had some concerns about this rezoning because the whole block that is in that part to be rezoned, I'm afraid it sets a precedent. Right now, the whole block is residential areas, the yellow. My fear is that once this is rezoned, it's going to set a precedent for that block, which is all residential. Also, the buildings that she mentioned, like Watson's office, faces Tombs. It does not face Wayne. The pregnancy support building faces Oak. Neither one of those have concerned me whatsoever. But you've got this neighborhood, Fairfield Place, that has 9 houses right across the street, which is family residences. It worries me about the parking. I think if that is paved in front, it's going to be an eyesore for the neighborhood. And I've had, several people say that they would not have even bought houses right there if they knew that it would be rezoned. So those were my main concerns. The main one, it sets a precedent for that whole block across the street from Fairfield to be rezoned at some point.
Is there anyone else tonight who wishes to speak against this request?
Several, but the setting of precedent, and all the houses on that block, on the block are residential, and I had an issue with maybe some safety concerns, like Marcia was saying about the Fairfield area. It's densely populated, and there's children over there, and plus next door to me, there's children there too. It just seems like it's not really, too much activity going on. There are people that jog and walk their dogs down the street. It doesn't really kind of make sense to me in that area for the reasons that I said and also the reasons that Marcia brought up.
Thank you,
Ms.
Thank
you.
All right, is there anyone else who would like to speak against?
I'm William Hodges, 2214 Fairfield Place. I just wanted to make my objection to her. It's the same thing, precedent being set, being an eyesore. What it would do to the rest of the neighborhood. And once it's zoned, there's no stopping them from tearing it down and creating something else there. That could be even more than eyesore and ruin the neighborhood.
Okay.
And traffic. There's enough coming out of Fairfield Place.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Hodges. All right. Is there anyone else who would like to speak against this request? We have time for one more. All right, if not, I'll turn it back over to the commissioners. Any discussion? Questions for staff? All right, if not, I'll ask for the motion.
Madam Chair.
Yes, Commissioner Wills.
This is a rezone request that I think is a little bit different. I don't view this as being a transitional neighborhood or an area as if it's a bakery or somewhere that's on. decision. I do understand the concerns, and I think it probably will be inappropriate at the present time there. So I make the motion that we recommend denial for this request.
All right, we have a motion to deny. Do I have a second?
A second.
Okay. Any discussion on that motion? All right, all those in favor of the motion to deny, please raise your right hand. And all those against, and the motion carries.